Hi, my name is Kai, and I'm a stylist and a content creator and a designer.
Awesome, I love your style. So tell me what you're wearing.
So this is a thrifted biker type athletic top. These pants are from Jaded London. These are some Yeezy boots. I thrifted this purse, but it's from JW Pay. The hat is from Aime. The glasses are thrifted. The pearl necklace I got at like a table on the street in Paris. Then the rings are mostly thrifted. I got this in Paris. My friend went to Japan and got me this. And I think that's pretty much it.
Awesome. All right. So where would you like to go shopping?
I'm actually about to go thrifting. Probably like at 2nd Street or like there's this cool store called like Thrift Shop.
All right. So where do you get your fashion inspiration from?
I honestly stopped looking for inspiration as much. I kind of just like go with how I'm feeling, and I guess like the only inspiration is just more so just like living in New York and seeing everyone dress how they want to dress, and like I'm like, wow, I never thought to wear something like that. So I guess that's like the only inspiration is other people.
Hi, what's your name and what do you do for a living?
Hi, my name is Isabella Carr and I'm a model.
I love your style, so lovely. So tell me what you're wearing.
I am wearing a thrifted hat, Hope Macaulay sweater. Again, thrifted, and then a vintage Louis Vuitton travel bag. Yeah.
Thank you. So where would you like to go shopping?
I honestly feel like any vintage designer store is my calling. I feel like all my pieces I find online on like vintage designer resale stores. So any one of those, I don't think I have a fave. I like digging for a treasure, so.
Where do you get your fashion inspiration from?
I would say my fashion inspiration comes from New York in general. In the streets, you see such amazing fashion. People from Queens, Brooklyn, they always bring heart and spirit and such a unique perspective on clothing and expression. So I feel like just New York, being from New York, it makes me very inspired, so.
Hi, what's your name and what do you do for a living?
Hi, I'm Carolina. I work as a studio manager for a photographer and then also as a personal assistant to a model, Isabella, who you just interviewed.
Awesome. All right, so I love your style and tell me what you're wearing.
Okay, this hat is Isabella's. She got it in Bed-Stuy, I think, just like at a street vendor, but they have these all over New York. This puffer is from Theory. It's my favorite. It's so warm and soft. Underneath it, I'm wearing... doesn't matter. These are my boyfriend's jeans, actually, which is funny. This is Alexander Wang, also my boss's. And then these shoes are ASICS. Yeah.
Awesome. All right, so where would you like to go shopping in New York City?
I also like a lot of like thrifted or like vintage stores. I love flea markets. Like the Dumbo Flea is really fun for accessories and like all sorts of stuff. Yeah, any vintage like fair, like things like that, love to shop. When I go to Europe, because I think the vintage stores there are just like elite. Yeah, honestly, a lot of like vintage stores are like online, yeah.
Hi, so what's your name and what do you do for a living?
My name is Marquez Martin and I make music.
Awesome, all right, so great outfit. So tell me what you're wearing.
I don't know, I wasn't expecting to be interviewed, so I just put on something cozy. You know, I got this like vintage cropped hoodie. I don't know, I just like, found it on the street one day. I don't know what it says, but I don't know. What does it say? Looks. I don't know what it said, whatever. Just wearing a t-shirt, my friend's brand, Pantamolle. Wearing some Wranglers. And then I'm wearing the Aime Leon Dore clogs. What else? Oh, this is a Tiffy's necklace. Yeah. Warby Parker.
Good one. Thank you so much. All right. So you do music. Like, who is your favorite artist?
Right now, my favorite artist is Eve's Tumor.
Awesome. All right. So where do you get your fashion inspiration from?
Oh, right now, if I'm just being honest, I'm just going for not what everyone else is wearing, but also comfortable. I don't know. Kind of just playing with like crop stuff recently. I don't know, this is like vintage guy, designer, his name is JC Castelbajac. Like he's like some really cool stuff. I've been wearing all of that recently.
Hi, what's your name and what do you do for a living?
How you doing guys? It's Barry Love. I'm a musician and I'm a curator. I have all this accustomed curated things I have right here, accumulated just over the years doing things. I love fashion, always been in the life for drift. Anyway, you want to know what I'm wearing today?
I want to know what you're wearing.
Let me see. Well, right now I have this Carl Kanai racing jacket. It's like a cool vintage piece. Always loved how good construction they are. Nice waterproof, rain resistant Carhartt under. I have these Maharishi pants on right now. It's a cool background jump. I really like this vibe. The red Louis Vuitton trainers. The Fendi monster hat with the Zucker print. And the little casual polo sport bag. It's my good every day. I feel so much stuff in here.
Awesome. All right, so tell me about your store here at the corner of North
7th
and Bedford.
North 7th and Bedford. I've been doing this for a while. Just kind of collecting things. And I started a few years back to coming out here with one of my friends. And then it just kind of grew from there. And I've been expanded. I have multiple locations in the city. So if you see the rack around with the cow print and the vibes, you know what's up. Soon actually getting a physical location, working on it. And that's gonna be hopefully in the next few months.
So tell me your top three items from your store.
Top three items from the store right now. Probably this Kenny Scharf. I love this Heron Preston collab. Really interesting, super limited design they did. You got this Vivian Westwood clutch that's like really interesting. I love how the size is. It's like kind of a good everyday size. The classic polo, but this is actually a really rare polo sport hat if you know. You can't find one of these for less than $1,000 anywhere. Yeah. Right now, the cheapest one you could probably find for this is on average, they're going for about $899 plus $99 shipping. So they want like $1,000 for this.
That's pretty dope. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Thank you for showing.
Yeah, thanks for stopping by.